I do know some widows or widowers, when they've got into a new relationship, what happens is, you know, friends and family, they tend to say, you know, why has he or she got in the new relationship? They shouldn't be. Wow. And, you know, that there's a sort of gossiping happening behind the scenes. So it's quite a difficult situation for that person as well, who wants to move on. And rightly so, they have the right to move on. However, a lot of times you may not get the support from your family and friends.
But yeah, so what we're looking at today, Ronald?
Yeah, I remember I was 3 years old. You know, you can recall back. We're talking 70-odd years ago. I was 3 years old. My grandfather took me into the garden, and he did a phenomenal thing for me. He was picking up all the herbs like parsley, thyme, you know, oregano, and he was cutting with this garden knife. And he was putting it under my nose. He, remember, 3 years old, he was putting it under my nose. And he used to smell that. And I'm like, wow. Wow. You know, so I got this habit of knowing about herbs, understanding about herbs, and then smelling fresh herbs from our own garden.
Okay.
Now,
That's what my wife does, but she does it with food.
Yes.
Like, she just has to smell everything. I don't know why, but anyway.
Yeah. Well, it's what you call the olfactory system of, you know, your nose, because your nose can play a big part in how you're going to enjoy your food. Mm-hmm. If your food smells right, you're going to really enjoy your food, chew it well, you're going to take your time, and take your time, T-H-Y-M-E, as well, you know. So
Hugo agrees with you. I'm just afraid that you're encouraging her. Go on ahead.
That's right. So this time, T-H-Y-M-E. Now, remember, you got time. She has pronounced time. And you got time. Time, you see?
Thyme.
T-H-Y-M-E. In French, they call it le teint. Like T-H-Y-M-E. So it's one of the most phenomenal herbs. And you know, it goes back to the Egyptians. You know that?
Oh, wow.
It goes back to, we're talking 2,000 years ago.
Okay.
They found thyme seeds and dried leaves in the tombs of the pharaohs. That's how far back it goes. And so it's native to the Egyptians. It's also native to the Mediterranean region and some parts of Africa. But now, it's worldwide, right? So now, the resume for, you know, for the nutritional part of it, have a listen to that. It's got vitamins, minerals, antioxidants, which fights the free radicals, phytonutrients, which means plant nutrients, or nutrients deriving from plants. That's what phytonutrients means.
Yeah.
Polyphenols, which is a very strong form of anti.
We love
polyphenol
them.
Is poly means multiple, right? Dietary fibers, and it's also got dietary fibers, magnesium, manganese, which these are rare. Manganese, zinc, selenium, which is great for internal health, vitamin A for the eyes, vitamin C for the collagen in your tissues, vitamin E, vitamin K for blood clotting, and proper treatment of the blood, thiamine, which is a B-complex vitamin, potassium, and it's also got a cryptoxanthin, which is great for the eyes. So I remember my grandfather using a thyme tea for his wife, grandmother, every day, once a day. They'd make this thyme tea, TX1. They would make take 2 or 3 tablespoons of thyme leaves, fresh from the garden.
Yes.
Put boiling water on it, and that's all he'd use. Sometimes he'd put ginger with it, but what the benefits are? Just there's about 35 known benefits.
I mean,
just quickly, 35 benefits. and we're just going to rummage quickly through it. Antibacterial, antifungal, antioxidant, improves blood circulation, keeps the cardiovascular system healthy, good for the eyes, good for the immune system, reduces stress, respiratory problems at bay,
mm-hmm.
relief from inflammation, digestive system healthy. I can vouch for that. If ever you had a heavy meal and you make a time in it, you digest or you make tea with it.
Okay. I had that yesterday.
Right, good.
I wish I had time tea.
You wish you had it.
Yeah.
You had it.
Because I had a heavy meal yesterday because I had an Ultimate Grill and I needed it yesterday. Yeah.
And the more eaten that meat was, that you would have needed the time even more because, you know, when you eat that really tough cooked meat, it's not good. It lasts 92 hours in the stomach. Oof. That's how long it takes to digest.
Anyway, still in me.
Time is good for sleeping. Okay. It does diuretic benefits. So if you've got edema, you can eat thyme or make thyme tea.
Mm-hmm.
It's reduced the risk of various types of cancers, keeps our liver healthy, improves cognitive functions of the brain, regulates blood sugar, manages the bad cholesterol level. It's also very, very good for skin health, because it improves collagen production in your skin. Right, it reduces skin pigmentation,
mm-hmm.
Aids in the treatment of acne. We're nearly there. Wow. Improves skin radiance. Right, not many people can say that. Aids in skin tonification, and it's also good for hair growth. It prevents hair loss. Ooh. It aids in treating dandruff. You can make it like a tea, and then you can rub the thyme tea in your brain, in your scalp.
Yeah,
for about leave it there for half an hour and then rinse off.
Okay.
And that gets through the dandruff, right? And it also makes your hair strong and lustrous.
Ooh.
And last but not least, it can help you with it when you get acne in your scalp as well.
Oh wow!
So, you know, my favorite way to eat thyme, you can make tea with it.
Mm-hmm.
And when I make tea with thyme, we've got all this growing here in the garden. So my favorite combination is thyme, olive leaves,
mm-hmm.
raspberry leaves, and cafelante leaves, right? Now, you put those things, you can also put ginger. Mm-hmm. So when you put boiling water on these four or five ingredients, right, remember, cafelime, olive leaves, thyme, and so on, and garlic, and you can do all that, right?
Did you say cafelime?
Cafe, yeah, there's different types of lime. This one's called K-A-F-F-I-R, Kaffir lime.
Okay.
I believe it comes from South Africa. That's where the name Kaffir comes from.
Mm.
And it's almost like a lemon, and it's evergreen and beautiful big leaves.
Oh wow!
And very flavoursome. And when you cook, say for example, chicken, you put Kaffir lime leaves in it. You put thyme tea. You put thyme. I mean thyme, but we tablespoon a lot. You've got to strip the leaves are very small, so you've got to strip the leaves off the stem of the flower. Now there's many, many types of thyme, but the one I like the most, believe it or not, is what they call common thyme. It's got a unique flavour.
Mm.
So if you crush it between your fingers before you have to cook, and you smell it, it's just like oh wow. Mm. And then in chicken, particularly, and with sea bass, it is very flavoursome. And so that's the way you do it. But a word of warning, don't buy thyme that's dried from the supermarket.
So,
don't.
Okay, so let me
You're
repeat
wasting
that.
Your money.
So don't buy thyme
yep.
that's dried.
Yep. Yes, don't.
Because that's normally because what you get in the marketplace. It's normally pretty dry.
Correct. Yeah, in a supermarket, yeah. You must, the reason why is because, you see, it is such a oily plant. It's full of oil, right? And the oil is the actual medicine. The oil out of the thyme, like thyme oil, is the medicine. And it's not only that, that's the one that provides the flavor in your mouth, the taste. Right? Now, the moment you dry it, you can use it dry, but I tell you what, you're not even going to get one-fifth of the flavor.
Wow.
Right?
So we're actually shortchanging ourselves by buying it dry. So, oh, wow.
Yeah. And thyme is evergreen. And look, even if you've got a small balcony, you can put a pot size, about 12-inch pot, you can put one or two types of thyme in that on the windowsill or outside in the balcony, and you can have that for the rest of your life.
Ooh.
As long as you keep it fed.
Here's one. Just to interject. Mijuli, can you do me a favor? Can you just do a video, Mijuli, of your thyme plant? Yeah. Just to show, and I'll share it to the Breakfast Show faithfuls on the WhatsApp line and also on the Facebook for them to have a look to see how easy it is to grow as well.
Very good. And so it is one of the easiest plants to grow. And the only thing that you should do is in winter, when it gets like snowy or a bit icy, you should really put it in a protective area, like maybe under a canopy, or just put it indoors for a few days. But as soon as it gets to, say, 14 degrees, out. Put it out, right?
Mm-hmm.
I've got about six varieties of thyme growing in the back garden here.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, you ain't seen nothing until you see the flowering thyme. Wow. That is one of my biggest bee drawers. You know, I've got these big bumblebees and the normal bees, and I've got this pot, right? It's a very good, it's quite expensive. It's like a ceramic type pot. It's quite a big size, about 12 inches wide. And I've put flowering thyme in it. The flowers are just spectacular.
Wow.
It's like a canopy.
Wow, we've even got beautiful. It on the screen right now. Wow, beautiful.
Beautiful, isn't it? And what's fantastic with it, it gives you another huge benefit if you grow your own. Mm-hmm. If you've got fruit trees, or you've got roses and you've got other plants like that, the bees come for the thyme, right? And they draw the honey from the flowers, and then they go and pollinate your fruit trees.
Mm.
So you get more apples, you get more apricots, you get more plums, because the bees are allowed to come to this flowering thyme. And in fact, the bees are so familiar with me, they actually come and land on my hands. they can smell me. They know, right?
Wow, you sound like Snow White. Like all the animals is like...
Yeah. Well, you know, the animals know. They know when someone's got a good soul because, you know, they follow you around. You're not going to believe this, but I've got a little robin. He's got a beautiful red crest on his chest, right?
Mm-hmm.
He comes and sits on the actual periphery of the pot of the thyme, and you can see him smelling it. and I will go 3 feet from him. He won't budge. He'll be sitting there, and he'll look at me, and then he'll go. They know what they're doing. Absolutely, you know. So there's nothing more relaxing than having a robin like talk to you.
Wow.
Amazing, isn't it?
Absolutely.
So, go to the garden shop, good one. Find about two or three types of thymes, but get the first one you should get is a flowering thyme, and because that one you can use like a spring, and it'll be flowering for about 3 or 4 months,
mm-hmm.
and so that's the one you use for your chicken, fish, lamb, and so on.
Mm-hmm.
Excellent for flavor, excellent. Okay. And my grandmother used to stuff the thyme quite a bit of it in the actual gully of the chicken, like, you know, the actual inside, and, you know, that's where you put your flavouring. She put a lot of thyme in there,
mm-hmm.
put ginger in there, and garlic in it, and the chicken, oh my goodness, would melt in your mouth, you know, like that.
Wow.
So this is the benefit of having your own thyme gut plant in your garden. All these benefits of health.
Fantastic.
As well as a pleasure of having birds basically talk to you. Amazing.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. So get some thyme, make tea with it. The oils of the thyme is everything that you need, is a taste of flavor and all the goodness that it contains. And you can also get the one that's fresh. And if possible, grow your own.
Yeah, grow your own.
Brilliant.
Very easy to grow. If anybody wants any tips, look at our website, Planet Wellness.
Yep.
And then you'll see it's mentioned in there.
Excellent. And if you could just put the link to that on the channel, please.
Just a correction. Just correct me. If I keep calling it a website, it's actually on YouTube.
Okay.
So YouTube.
So check Planet Wellness on YouTube.
I hope you enjoyed that.
Yeah. I have a new insight for thyme, and I'm going to go out and start hunting for fresh thyme. Definitely. Mm. And we've got a month as well with this snack of the three celeries and almond butter to go through. So we're going to start working. We're going to work on that with all of our Breakfast Show faithfuls. So it's going to be powerful stuff. It's going to be powerful stuff.
Well, believe it or not, see, just an idea just came to me. You could, if you plan your own time, especially flowering time, you could use the organic celery, put the almond butter as like a inside the boat, you know, the celery, like the celery stem,
the stick,
and then you could put a few leaves of thyme, just a few leaves of thyme in the flour, in the middle of your almond butter, and that would give you enormous benefits. You'd have all the benefits of the celery, the protein, and the alkaline effects of the almond, and then the thyme would be just a beautiful taste. I mean, it'd be unique. Not many people would use that. You know?
Well,
that would really be great.
I'm on that program. So, guys, this is the Breakfast Show, and that's the great thing about Ronald with the extensive wellness tip. We start to appreciate the things that we have access to on a daily basis and understand clearly why we are using them. All right, and the impact of this is so invaluable for our health and well-being going forward. So those of you like Miss Mildred, who gave me feedback on the WhatsApp line, if you want to give us some feedback, you can get us on the WhatsApp line, and the WhatsApp line number is +44 75 79 79 6845, and let us know how you're going on with the the tips that that Ronald is sharing with you, because we love to hear about it and we love to hear your progress. And obviously visit the YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/C/PlanetWellness, where you can check out more stuff, more material that they have, more insights. You're going to get to see their faces live on screen, comment on their material, get in there, get robust, just chat and communicate with them. You're going to be on Facebook later on today as well, right?
Yes, we are at 1:30 p.m.
So every Wednesday at 1:30 p.m. UK time, Ronald Petrina have the Planet Wellness on Facebook. So connect with that. Just get involved. And if you want to see their old programs and see links to their materials, you can also check the Robust Life TV, because I'm Robert, your Robust presenter. And we have Robust Life TV, where we have the Breakfast Show interviews on there. Where you can literally, if you see the video with Ronald Petrina on it, which has their material, you will get links also to their channels as well. But also you can go straight to their channels, and it's just, everything's available for you. It's all for you. It's for you all. It's just all for you. All right, guys. So that's it. We're done for today. Breakfast Show is done. Thank you so much for a wonderful, phenomenal morning, Ronald Petrina. You two are absolutely amazing.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Connect online Monday to Friday with special guests for inspiration, motivation to start your morning right. Music, banter, fun and laughter. Connect when you start your mornings with The Breakfast Show. Only on libertyradio.co.uk. That's right, The Breakfast Show is back. libertyradio.co.uk from 6:30 a.m.